Okay, we are live from the Void Loop 2, second running the Void Loop stage. We're waiting for Travis Pastrana, who has just started. We are at the jump. Last we heard that Pastrana is still currently leading over David Higgins by, 13 point something seconds? So he's held on to the lead that he had last night. That's larger than how much they were separated with the finish last year. So we'll have to see if we can hold on to that. But very excited to see how far these guys jump. And see who still holds on to the lead. Oh, that's right. I forgot to mention we have not only jump markers, but we have a speed gun, so we'll be able to tell their speed as well as the distance they are jumping. So, should be just a few more minutes. Like I said, Pastrana has started, and we will be getting going here very shortly. Also hear that car 75, which is David Higgins, has also started. What mile marker are we at? About 5 miles? Yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah, like 5.1 or something.
So those of you at home, that if you have a stopwatch and you want to see if there's a gap between them, the cars are starting one full minute apart. So if you have a stopwatch, you can actually see at this point anyways. Who's gaining on who? Just use a little lap counter on it, and you can find out what their separation is. If it's less than a minute, then Higgins is gaining on Pastrana. If it's more than a minute, Pastrana is still pushing. No, we don't have any helicopters this year, Ian.
Starting to hear cars in the distance.
Yep. We can hear in the distance, echoing off of some of the valleys here, the sounds of the cars. Still a little ways out yet. Here we see something coming.
Yeah, just take a step back and show up.
Yep.
And then step back forward.
Right. All right, Seahorn has now started. And Pastrana's almost here. That was somewhere around 115 feet, I'd say.
Right around there, right around 120.
So, we're around 115, 120 feet. We made the markers out to 120. 104 whopping miles an hour. I would call that a never lift. We have some differing opinions on the exact distance. This is our first time doing this, but somewhere between 120 and 125 is what the folks on the other side are saying. They're a little closer to, we got some scrub brush in our way, so.
Pastrana told me last year he lifted before the, or he lifted the entrance to jump a little bit and lost the second and a half to Higgins between the jump and the spectator.
Right, so apparently last year Pastrana said that he had lifted just a little bit before the jump because he wasn't quite as straight on as he wanted to. And he thinks he lost a full second here last year. Based on what we saw today, I'm thinking he got that second back. Higgins starting to come up now. And here he is. Okay, 110 miles an hour, and you thought it was 97 feet, is what you were thinking?
Vice versa.
Oh, sorry.
110 feet.
110 feet, 97 miles an hour. There we go. It did seem just shorter from what Pastrana was. So.
It was
oh, look at them in the distance back there. I know it's a wide angle on our camera that we've got here, but you can see that rooster tail. Oh, look at that. It's great. All right, so it should be Seahorn that's coming up next.
Yeah, they just go.
Seahorn told me in the service that they actually had a small problem with their exhaust, so they're working on patching that up. They think it might have lost them just a little bit of horsepower. Or they just don't want to break it any more than otherwise, so they might take it a little easier, but we'll see what happens. Yes, Ian, you're right. The top drivers out there will say too much time in the air can be time wasted, but I don't know. 110 miles an hour was pretty damn quick.
Is that what he had?
Or was it 10?
He was at 10.
No, that was Higgins. What was Pastrana again?
Oh, 104.
104, okay. So it wasn't 110, it was 104.
You gotta get a little more in front of the mic. We're having some trouble here.
Okay. So it's gonna take a little bit longer for Seahorn to get here, being the lower powered car, but I think I see a dust trail. Yep, here he comes. So 91 miles an hour at 80 feet. Seem to be impressed. Putting on a little show over there, I think. Yep, here's the next car. Is this a Rimmer or? Oh no. So that was Eric Gruska. And it was about, well, how many feet?
About 50 or 60.
About 50 feet, yeah, it looked like it was about 40 to 50 to me. So I'd say about 50 feet, and what was the speed on that one? 73 miles an hour. So taking a little easier.
And that was car number 198?
Yeah, 198, Eric Gruska.
We're going to do 55, let's put the difference at
70. She's asking about the Fiesta. They had engine problems. They didn't start the day.
The Fiesta S2000 ended up having some engine issues after last night. I remember when I was talking to them, they were having some overheating issues of some sort. Anyways, they're still working on those, so they did not start. Oh, here we go again. This time we have... That would have been the Nameless BRZ with Steven Red at the wheel.
Right about 100 feet.
100 feet?
At 88.
88 miles an hour. All right. Sure felt faster than that, I'll tell you that.
Ah, we just saw some serious shit.
Right? That was cool. Well, they've been working really hard on the BRZ. I was talking to the Nameless guys, and one thing they had a problem with last year is traction. They have all that power, but getting it to be able to deliver it to the wheels where they didn't just spin was very tough. And they've improved it quite a bit this year. And I apologize, I do not have a start order with me, so we're just gonna be going off what we see. Here comes another car. All right, here comes another competitor. I guess it'll be a two-wheel drive, guys. Yep, Millen.
About 75 at 80.
So, 75 feet at 80 miles an hour. Yeah, try doing that in your automatic.
Wow. Got another one coming already. Somebody's catching.
Kaufman, the drifter.
That means Millen caught him.
They did about 70 at 76.
Yeah, so Millen caught Kaufman.
Did you hear the starts? Unless they did a reseed.
Okay.
Or at regroup, they might have readjusted who starts when.
Okay. I don't know.
Yeah, we'll have to double check on if Millen ended up catching Kaufman or if they changed the start order with the regroup. Those two are obviously very close. All right. I will try and talk loud. Sorry, we were using a directional mic here, and of course it's directed towards the cars and not towards me. So we'll try and improve the voice quality here. Alright, that was Cameron Steely, 80, also a never lift.
80 at 82.
So, 80 feet, 82 miles an hour. This is a stage he said he really likes. Now we'll be able to gain that time back on Millen.
Yeah, it's not the case.
probably going to be Wallingford. Nope, Travis Neese. Feet, 82 miles an hour. Well, looks like he's trying to catch up to Seahorn. If he can. Times in. I'm just trying to look at this up real quick on my phone here. Pastrana finished the stage and wait a minute. Nope. Sorry. Wrong stage. Oh. That was Rimmer.
110 at 92.
Woo! That's the production four-wheel drive.
No,
in there,
R-O.
Is it? Is it Izarro?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, that's right. It's Kaufman that's in production. I got the two mixed up. James Rimmer, that was damn far.
Do we have a number?
Was it? Yeah.
25.
No, what was the distance again?
Oh, 110.
110 feet, and at what speed? Just to repeat it.
92 miles an hour.
92 miles an hour, if you guys heard that. What? 55 feet?
65 feet.
65 feet, and what speed?
72 miles an hour.
72 miles per hour for those two. So again, that was Dave Wallingford and his co-driver, Leanne Janilla. Alejandro Persuna.
Did about 75 at 68.
So 75 feet at 68 miles an hour. Regional's giving some of the national guys a run for their money. Probably saw the impact there. That was Derek Knight in the old Volvo 242, and
about 75 feet at 77 miles an hour.
So 77 miles an hour, 75 feet, and you know what? I bet it barely scuffed the bumper on that thing. That car is a tank.
Thank you.
was Mark Tabor, local racer, in his open four-wheel drive of the regionals.
He was a square, 75 at 74.
All right, so 74 miles an hour, 75 feet. That's the car they call Larry Lemur, if I remember correctly. Buffeting, the wind picked up just a little bit here as the sun went away.
Two James May impression. Buffeting. Buffeting.
Yes, that was Kevin Cardos, number 500. Normally aspirated open four-wheel drive, it's a 95 Subaru 2.5 RS.
He got about 80 feet.
But they're saying it was only 53 miles an hour, but I'm sure it was a little faster
than
that.
It seemed a little faster than 53.
Unless it had wings to fly farther, yeah, it doesn't quite compute with the other guys. Another one coming. That was Blake Lind of Primitive Racing. 75 feet at 78 miles per hour, is that correct, sir?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. That's again another one of those normally aspirated open four-wheel drive cars. Regional, his wife is his co-driver. Probably happens outside the race car as well. Tell them where to go.
Yeah, no, I
with the car number. Did you catch the car number?
I did not. It was a red STI.
Yeah, another STI. I know that was one of the regionals. So you guys have to look that one up.
Thank you.
Jared Bent, car number 503, another regional.
He was about 65 and 72.
All right, 65 feet, 72 miles an hour, rather consistent around here, apparently. From 503. I always remember that one because it's our area code out here. Going for the distance award of the regionals, I think. Hold on, the wind is really bad. It was 105 feet and 89 miles an hour. That is a Subaru Legacy sedan, non-turbo. An old one at that. We got some banner tape floating.
John Hill,
that's right. Billy Irvin as a co-driver, that's right. And so again, it was how many feet?
50 feet at 66.
So if you guys didn't hear that, that was 50 feet at 66 miles per hour. Tracy Manspeaker is a co-driver.
Yeah.
Who's the driver?
Jonathan Sharples.
Oh, Sharples.
Yeah.
Andy Sharples.
He did about.
So we got Andy Sharples with Tracy Manspeaker. They, well, mostly just like the suspension. Come on, let's be honest here. If there was actually air that got under the tires, it was maybe 10, 15 feet. Noisemaker coming. You can hear it a long ways away. 88 miles an hour. A lot of rear wheel drive fun going on there. Kevin Walsh in car 673, another regional, normally aspirated open four-wheel drive. What was his speed in that?
He was about 40 at 67.
Okay, so 40 feet, 67 miles an hour. Gearman. So about 20 feet maybe, 61 miles an hour. Looked like he almost missed a gear trying to, as he was heading up to the jump, he was a little slow at getting it into the next gear. Miles an hour. Not bad. She keeps getting faster and faster, jumping a little farther every time. On the jump last night, she said that she closed her eyes because it made her nervous. Maybe she closed her eyes on this one. You can also look up the times yourself, either with the ARA Rally app. You can also go to the ARA webpage, also OregonTrailRally.com. There's a link that says live, and you click on that, and it should show you some of the times for the drivers as they come through to the finish. Yeah. Gave it a good little bunny hop. Shows you how much of a difference the approach speed is to how far you to get any jump distance here. It's very exponential. that's it.
Let me look up their names here. I know I talked to them last
Chris
night.
Chris Hamrick and Jay.
That's right. So Chris Hamrick is the driver of that car. 43 miles an hour. Yeah, they were actually, you could hear them on it before the jump. And then they suddenly just lifted and cut the speed. Number that is, but that was
626.
Okay. Jump 51 miles an hour. Asking what happened to Dave Clark in the XR4TI Mercure. Unfortunately, we happened to pass him as we were coming up to this stage, parked on the side of the road at the end of, I think it was a previous run of this. and had the hood off of it, and it was just sitting there parked to the side. So apparently he has mechanicals. You can go to the ARA Rally app, download it from the App Store for Apple, as well as to Google Play for your Android phones, and it has the timing there, as well as the maps that you can watch the